Hello everybody and welcome back. Zendy Rubik here with a new tutorial. And today I'm gonna show you guys how you can create a 3D hair using Blender. And with this method, you can create any anime character hair you wish to. Before we dive into our tutorial, I wanted to share with you guys one of the most valuable tools I use to land gigs and showcase my work. It's called ReelCrafter. ReelCrafter is a customizable portfolio builder designed specifically for creatives. Whether you're a filmmaker, a composer, or an actor, ReelCrafter allows you to quickly build branded showreels, scissor reels, and press kits. One of the standout features of ReelCrafter is its detailed engagement tracking. Unlike typical portfolio websites, ReelCrafter gives you valuable insights into how decision makers interact with your portfolio. You can see every pose, play, download, and more. So you know exactly how your work is being received. With ReelCrafter, you can create individual share links for each recipient. This means you get detailed feedback on who viewed your work and what actions they took, helping you tailor your follow-ups and pitches more effectively. You can easily brand your reel with custom colors, images, and logos, ensuring that your portfolio looks professional and consistent with your personal or company brand. I've been using ReelCrafter to showcase my work and it has made a significant difference. For example, here is a reel I created using ReelCrafter. As you can see, it looks professional, and the feedback I get from the engagement tracking helps me understand what potential clients are interested in. Having a good portfolio is crucial for landing gigs. It not only showcases your skills, but also demonstrates your professionalism and attention to detail. With ReelCrafter, I'm able to present my work in the best possible light and get insights that help me improve my pitches and presentations. So if you are a creative looking to up your portfolio game, I highly recommend giving ReelCrafter a try. You can click on the link in description and start a 14-day pro trial to see how it works for you. Trust me, it's a game changer. And now, let us begin our tutorial.
Alright, so this is the Blender interface. Let's first delete our default cube, then change the camera position, X, Y, and Z to 0, the rotation as well, and the X rotation should be 90 degrees. Now select the camera and let's move it backwards. Now press Shift A and add a face builder head. If you don't have this option, then you should download the face builder head.
To enter or exit,
I will add a link down in the description where you can purchase it. Now I will press S and drag to scale it down. Then press Ctrl A and choose all transforms. And now let's go to edit mode. Select this circle. Now we're gonna start drawing on the head vertices on the places that we want the hair to grow on. So to draw, you have to press Shift and draw like so. If you don't press Shift, then the selection will be deleted every time you click. So hold the Shift and draw on the head like so. And if you want to delete some vertices, you can just press Ctrl and click to delete them. Now after you're done, you can go to the vertex groups and add a new vertex group. I will call it hair and click on assign. Now go back to the object mode and go to the particle system and add a new particle system. Click on hair. It's messy as you can see. So to fix this, we need to go down to vertex groups and assign all these groups to the vertex group we just created, which is hair. So I will assign all these groups like so. And now the hair will only grow on the vertex group we just created. So I will lower the hair length. Maybe lower. You can change the hair length depending on which character hair you want to create. I'm gonna change the segments to 7. And now go to material properties and add 2 new materials. On the second material, I will choose the color of the hair. In this case, I'm creating Gojo Satoru's hair, so the color will be some white bluish color. And as you can see, nothing changed, so we will want to go back to the particle settings and under render, change these material options to material 2. Now if you go to the rendered view, we can see the color has changed to this color. I'm gonna change the color just a bit. And now go back to the particle system, check the hair dynamics and click on advanced. Now go down to children and change it to interpolated, so the hair gets more volume as you can see. You can always play around with the display amount and render amount to your desire. Okay, now I'll go to the render settings and check ambient occlusion, screen space reflections, motion blur, and under curves, you can change it to strip if you want. Now go to the rendered view and let's see how it looks. I'm gonna move my light like so. Press 0 to enter the camera view mode to see how it looks. Okay, I think I'm gonna change it back to strength. Now going back to the particle system, under hair shape, I will lower the diameter to 0.2 or maybe less, 2.2. And now let us move to the particle edit mode. Now I'm gonna start stylizing the hair. So I'm going to use the comp tool, and you can press F and drag to change the radius. Now enter tool and options, check children. Okay, so before we start stylizing the hair, we need a reference. And for this one, my reference is going to be Gojo Satoru. So I will use this image as a reference and then start stylizing the hair. And also don't forget to lower this distance value so the hair doesn't go up as you stylize it. Now I'm gonna start stylizing the hair. You can use the cut tool to cut the hair if it's too long. And use the add tool to add more hair strands. So this tutorial won't be a hair stylizing tutorial. That's why I'm gonna speed up the stylizing process. But if you really want to learn how to stylize the hair, just leave me a comment below and I will create a tutorial on how to stylize the hair. If you press A, then press H, you're going to hide all these hair strands. And then you can add some new hair strands without messing around with the old ones. Again, you press A to select all these hair strands, then press H to hide them. And when you add new hair strands, you will only be able to stylize the new added hair strands. And you can always play around with the children values. I will increase the display amount like so. And under the roughness, you can increase the threshold, shape, and endpoint to your desire. If you press Shift F, then drag, you can control the strength of the comp tool. So after you finish the stylizing, you can move back to the object mode and let's see how it looks. Okay, perfect. So now I will go down to the children and play around with the clump value. And in the render settings, I'm gonna change it to strip to see how it looks. Okay, I think this strand is better. I'm gonna change it back to strand. Let's see how it looks in cycles. Cycles quality is a lot better, but it takes too much time to render. So let's go back to the Evee. Gonna go back to the clumping and increase both clump and shape. Also enable clump noise, and under roughness, let's see what these values does. Alright, so now go to the physics tab and add a collision. Go back to the particle system and increase the quality steps to 20 and the pin goal to 0.4 looks fine. Now under collisions, change the quality to 5 and lower the distance. Now under cache, choose your interval frames. For me, it's 250 frames and click on bake. Start baking the animation. So after it's done, it's time to render our animation. So the first thing to do is to choose your output folder. Make sure the file format is PNG and the color is set to RGB alpha. And now first of all, we're gonna render this on Evee, and then I'm gonna show you how we can render it on cycles as well. All right, so first of all, I'm gonna add a new collection, then enable the mask like so and enable it for this collection. Now on the face builder head, press Shift D to duplicate and without moving your mouse, right click to let go. Now I will move the new copy to this collection. And under particle settings, just delete the particle system to get this look. Now in the render settings, under film, check transparent. And that's it. That's how you can render your hair animation in Evee. So now I'm gonna open up After Effects and show you how this one looks. So I will import my hair animation into a new comp, and this is how it looks. Let me create a new solid layer, change its color to green so you can see it more clearly. Move it like so, and this is it. But the quality of the Cycles renderer is much better, as I told you before. So now I'm gonna show you how you can render it in Cycles. So I will move this Facebuilder head copy back to the original collection, like so. And now on our original Facebuilder head, I will click on it, then go to particle settings, and under render and check show emitter, and under viewport display also and check show emitter. And now on our copy, I will go to the object properties and under visibility, check hold out. And then under render, change the render engine to Cycles, and that's it. That's how you can render your hair animation in Cycles.
That's it guys for this tutorial. That's how you can create a 3D hair using Blender. If you'd like to see more Blender tutorials, just let me know in the comments below. And now, don't forget to like, subscribe, and see you in the next video.